Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm walking you through on how you can add generative AI text effects in your projects in Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and check it out. Here I have a project opened in Adobe Express. I've already added an image here, a nice brick wall. I'm just going to make a few adjustments to this brick wall, maybe bring down the brightness, or maybe I'll bring it up, bring the contrast down. Let's take some of the saturation down. Really want to make it look grungy as the shadow. So let's go ahead and go with that. And now we're going to add some text here. And for this text, I'll click on the T and go ahead and add some text here. I'm going to add my name in all caps and I'm going to change the font. Right now it's set defaulted to Source Sans. I'm going to go with Alma. This one has a kind of a grungy look to it there, and you can see that text. I like that. I'm gonna go ahead and just center that on my screen here. And if you have a hard time seeing this because it's dark at the moment, so let's go ahead and just change the color to white just to make it visible. All right, so now what I'm going to do with the text selected is right down here within your effects panels here, animation, shapes, shadows, we have text effect. Now it is in beta at the moment. For the moment, it is only available for the public version of Adobe Express in beta. The EDU version does not have it just yet. So those of you who are in EDU, you can give this a try using a personal account for now, but hopefully it'll be available soon. What I've done here in the search box, or actually in the prompt box, is entered this prompt, spray painted graffiti, and then I can customize my text. It's defaulted to medium. I'm going to leave it as realistic. This tint option, we can see what that is. Now, these are all sample effects. I'll talk about those here in just a bit. But for now, I want to use my prompt, which is spray painted graffiti, and I'll click on generate and let's see what the results will show up. It's gonna take a little bit of time to think here and it should fill out. There we go. Awesome. Here are the results. I like that. That's really, really cool. You can click on all these different results to see a different style of graffiti that your, in this case, my name will show up. That's actually really cool. I like all these examples. These are all great. Ooh, I think I like that one right there. I may just leave it at this one. Now, what you can do here is in the tight option, medium and loose. We'll see, I'll go ahead and click on loose and just take a look at the outline to see how loose looks like. Maybe it'll look a little more spray painty style. Yeah, that looks really neat. I like that. I'm gonna go with keep it at the loose option. Now the background is a little, I think a little too dark, since maybe bring it down a bit. There we go. Just to make the letters pop up. Maybe make it a little blurred, yeah, just slightly, just to make the word pop up or my name there. Let's see. Because it's kind of drowning out there. Let's bring the brightness down, maybe right about there. There we go, just so we can see my graffiti there. That looks actually really neat. I do like that. I think I'm gonna leave it like that. And just to go back down here, you can change it to realistic. Let's see what embellish does, just to show you the differences. So you have different styles. As I mentioned, I did the realistic embellish. Yeah, that's pretty cool as well. So as you can see, the more you play with the different options here, you will get different results. And I think I'm gonna leave that the way it is. And we're gonna jump over to another project here. So I'm gonna go ahead and click up here. I've already got some projects already laid out. I should say some background set up. And for this one, I'm gonna play with, let's go ahead and type in creative here. And let's make the text white so we can see. And let's go ahead and change the font. Let's go with more of a block style, a little more filled out. And we're going to use industry. I'm going to make this larger. And let's see what comes up with this here. Actually, I think I'm going to go a little more, since say that style. There we go. So that's Bebas Nuo. I wanted a little bit of a taller font. So we're going to use that. And then for this prompt, we're going to have some fun here and go to the text effect. And here we have, let's describe this. I want a rusted cylinder pipe type of Text Effects. So let's see what happens. I'll click on Generate. And let's take a look at the results. We'll get some rusty looking pipes. And very cool. Yeah, I love that. That's neat. So here are the results. Let's look at all the different ones. So maybe I can get a little more. Let's see. Got some welding points. I mean, that's just amazing. I'm going to zoom in just so you can see. I mean, look at that. That's so cool. The welding points. And you can, again, go between the different ones and find the one that, you know, you like. This one seems to have some shadow effect. Gosh, that's just incredible. I think I'm going to leave it like that. And like I did with the other one, I'm going to go to my shadows here and just add a little shadow to that. Let's customize that shadow. Let's see if make it black. Let's see what that does. And let's not make it as blurry, less blurry like that. And let's bring the distance closer to the font. Just, I think that does a nice job of making the text pop out. I mean, this is simply amazing. Just the what you can do with this tool. Really, it's all based on your prompt, what you enter for your text effect. Now, as I mentioned, these are sample effects. I'm going to go ahead and show you. I think what I'll do is duplicate this page because I like the result. And so we'll duplicate this so I can keep that and open up a new one here. And then let's go ahead and show you all these different ones that are already there. I'm going to go ahead and view all. These are all samples that have already been generated. I'll click on balloon. And this literally looks like one of those balloon things that you go to one of those party stores to purchase or to set up. And here's the prompt, blue 3D rendered plastic smooth balloon. So the more specific you are, the better your results will be. Or I should say the better. I think you just get more detailed results. I don't want to say you'll get better results. You just get more detailed. So let's see what blue smoke looks like. I'm just curious here. Let's see the result for blue smoke. Kind of cool. Let's see what the prompt was. Blue smoke. Okay. So I think one of the things that I'm one that learns by kind of reverse engineering. So I'll go look at an example. And if I like the result, I'll just kind of teach myself on how to better prompt the generative AI tool here. If we have bark, which looks amazing. So let's see what the prompt was. Pine tree bark. Okay, cool. And so that is, in a nutshell, the generative AI text effect.
And that's how you can add generative AI text effects in your projects within Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. As always, be good to one another and have fun creating. Peace.